you can press, you can plug in the cruise altitude if you want to. It's not, we never do that because when we cleared our altitude, for example, when you get to speak with Copenhagen, you select, if you get 350, it will automatically plug 350 there.
Okay.
And then it uses that for the vertical navigation in the FMS. But we have the possibility, and we can plot in some winds as well if we want to. Not that we use that.
So it's very difficult to do.
Yeah. Yeah, 3-5. Yeah, by level 3-5-0, then you can say the wind is 360 or 300 or something, slash 100 knots maybe. So we have a lot of headwinds. So it calculates the time to press progress. Yeah, then that's estimated time elapsed. Okay.
Plus 11.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It uses the wind to calculate that.
Yeah.
But normally we're not plotting the winds. We never do that. Okay. Because when we get airborne, it gets some wind information and then it uses that. So
is it very difficult to learn all this?
No.
I learned it on my computer, that's it.
Really? Yeah, the FMS, you need to get it in your hands to get the hang of it. You cannot, there's a lot of FMS in the instrumentation subject, I believe, but you can only learn it by using it.
Yes. I can teach you in 2 hours.
Yeah,
no problem.
It's a learn by doing thing. So just press the performance lever. Performance in it, in the left, and then to skip to the fifth page, you can just press previews. Yes, exactly. So this is the last page in the performance. We plot in how many passengers, let's say 20. And then put it in the upper right corner.
In the upper right corner?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then it knows that we just use standard weights for passengers, 84 kilos.
Mm-hmm.
So we have a passenger weight and fuel on board, we have 18, 20. This is our fuel gauges.
Okay.
The small ones in the bottom in the load.
Okay.
Yeah. So just say 1800. And the fuel, yes. And then cargo, we have maybe 100 kilos of cargo. So. So then it calculates our gross weight, which is the same as our ramp mass.
Yeah.
And then you just press confirm this. And then it can calculate the time, the fuel, right? It's a little bit slow.
Yeah.
That's right. Now, time to destination, 54 minutes. Yeah. Fuel required, 1.3 tons. That's including the extra, the minimum reserve fuel.
Yeah.
So, if you want to, we can also press takeoff. This is in case of strong crosswinds and a slippery runway. Then we use this. We can maybe say 200, or what it was on the once you ride, then say 160, and then 30 knots maybe. And then put it on the wind, yes. So, and then you can press next on this thing. Then we have the crosswind component up here. Headwind and crosswind component. And then we check our papers. Okay, is this too much to land or depart on? Otherwise we rarely use that takeoff paper. And then so press the flight plan again. FBL. So now we're ready. We just have to put in our speeds, the reference data button on the middle screen there. Yes. Then we press take off speeds. And then press again, and now we have our flight director.